Hi guys, I have not done a video for YouTube in quite a while, and recently I found myself looking through YouTube trying to find a review of this armor, and no one's done it. From anything I can find, no one's done it. So here's my honest review of the Rubies Supreme Edition Shadowtrooper costume on Amazon. When I bought it, it was like $450. I saw it drop as low as $280 this year. It's now up to, I think, somewhere around $700. So if you're interested in it after you watch this review, then make sure to add it to your wish list on Amazon and then just watch the price drop, because chances are the price is gonna drop. So without further ado, here's my honest review of the armor. Despite the negative reviews and the really silly promo pictures of this armor on Amazon, I really do recommend this armor to anybody who is looking for a cheap alternative to a Stormtrooper armor and they're not really worried about movie authenticity. They're just looking for cool Stormtrooper armor to wear either for Halloween or to conventions. They're just looking for something simple. Now, with that being said, there's gonna be a lot of work you're gonna wanna do to this armor to make it fit you. It's made to fit a standard person. When whatever the hell standard means in Ruby's eyes, this armor did not fit my build, and I'm 5'11 and 120 pounds soaking wet, so tall and skinny, this armor don't fit very well. After you modify it, it fits you fine, which means a lot of replacing straps, a lot of replacing Velcro, and above all, taking a heat gun and reshaping a lot of the plastic so it can fit you better and not look like it's hanging off of you. This armor is honestly perfect for the person who doesn't really know what to do when it comes to making armor. They're really timid to buying individual pieces and building armor completely from scratch. They really don't know what to do if they end up going that route. This armor is a perfect way for them to go because it requires minimal, you know, changes, requires minimal maintenance to make it fit you, and it still looks the part. You still look like a Stormtrooper. If you're going to a convention, if you're not going for 501st approval, then you're still gonna look like a Stormtrooper. I mix and matched a bunch of different parts with my armor, obviously the white helmet being one of the biggest ones. I've created a huge, I don't even know how, huge fan base because of this armor and this helmet mashup on TikTok, and it works. This armor is not a bad choice for the person who is just looking for Stormtrooper armor. Quick little disclaimer, parts like these were not included with the armor. These were parts that I also bought off Amazon. This mag pouch is from Trooper Bay, the neck seal is from Trooper Bay, the pauldron, I'm actually not sure who that's from, but the other two parts I know are from Trooper Bay. The hand plates are actually a gift from a friend off of Instagram. Those did not come with the armor. These are the original hand plates. You see how they're kind of rounded? They don't really fit that well over your hand if you have big hands like I do. I only recently replaced these. You be the judge if these are actually worth it to you or not. I just couldn't make them work. Now, let's go over all of the modifications that I did to this armor to make it fit me the way that it fits me now. One of the easiest ways for me to show you guys how I did like the strapping and stuff, because I did a ton of modifications to this armor to make it to where it is now, is to basically take all it off and show you as I'm taking it all off, because I was already suited up for a TikTok video, so here we go. I mentioned to you guys that this part, and this part were not part of the armor originally. These were things I bought off Amazon, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how these, you know, go on the armor. Really simple with this piece especially. It's just two snap buttons right here. Unbutton it, and just kind of slide it off, and it has a strap underneath the actual fabric part to hold it onto your arm so it's not flapping around or anything. Again, you can find that on Amazon. I think Trooper Bay is the company that makes it. And then my mag pouches I have here are actually jimmy-rigged on, not that you can see, but they're all jimmy-rigged on with an elastic band that I bought at Walmart, like an elastic strap material with some Velcro on it, so it sits perfectly where I need it. One of the modifications I did to this armor was heating all the plastic components and shaping it to fit my body. This being one of them, these shoulder straps, I don't know, you know if you can see that because of the light glare on there, but these were bent, they're reformed and bent to be holding the chest plate where it needs to be, is up higher rather than sitting down here like the pictures look like on him. One of the things I did to this armor to make sure that my gauntlets stay on better was actually adding bits of foam inside here. You can barely see it. I'll get them off and I'll show you guys, just to help keep it actually on my wrist, because these have a tendency when you're standing up to kind of want to fall down. So in addition to my sleeves kind of being cuffed around it to hold them up, I also have that bit of foam inside of there. There's all of that foam just around the edge, just to help hold it in place, because they want to fall down. Now, if I would have left the straps that came off of these and were attached to the bicep plate, this wouldn't have been an issue. However, I wanted to have a little more mobility, wanted to be a little more free moving and not have something feeling like it's pulling, so I cut these straps off of it altogether. Again, another one of the things that makes this armor non-canon is exactly that. The original armor and all of the 501st approved kits have the forearm plates attached to the bicep plate by an elastic band. This is not meant to be canon whatsoever. So the chest plate, for those of you who don't have this armor, it is not does not have elastic bands. It just has strips of Velcro connecting the back and the chest plate. So I'll just pop these off. And this is actually cinched up because I have this modified to fit properly. It's super tight and there's no elastic bands across the top. I need to eventually do that. It's just not on top of my priority list. So this is kind of a pain to get off if you don't end up doing, if you don't do any kind of elastic bands or anything. I added additional Velcro to this back plate, to the back plate straps so I could have it cinched up tight enough and small enough to where it actually sits where it needs to sit on my body. They do, you know, hang down considerably more than they're supposed to, but again, it's not made to be movie accurate, it's made to just fit me. And here's the strapping, the elastic bands, the elastic strap that is all Velcroed and holding on the ammo pouch right here. Movie accurate trooper armor actually has the whole setup all stuck together, held together by elastic bands. So on the back here, you can see right there is where the elastic straps were, and they were cut off. I cut off basically all the elastic straps holding everything together, I removed so that this was easier to put on and offered me more mobility. Major difference with the way I have my strapping done for my armor versus the way that it's actually accurately done is this part right here. I have both shoulder bells connected by an elastic strap here on the front side and here on the back side. This allows me plenty of movement. I have no restrictions moving in my armor. I can run in my armor. I can do, not that running has anything to do with the shoulder bells, but I have an enormous amount of mobility in this armor. Having the elastic straps taken off of the chest plate and removed from, basically from being connected to the ab plate and the kidney plate, I'm able to rotate. I have full mobility in that sense. There's nothing kind of restricting me. Now granted, I'm not saying that any trooper that has movie accurate strapping on their armor is completely limited because of that. I'm just noticing a lot of troopers are limited by their movement. This is just all the modifications that I did to this armor. One of the other modifications that I did was connecting the bicep plate to the shoulder bell. So this is, again, how the armor is done if it's movie accurate. The biceps are attached. Obviously the forearm, bicep, and shoulder bell are all attached. I was tired of seeing people basically, not even people, but in the movies especially, seeing the bicep plate kind of rotating like this and you were seeing the underside. So I added straps inside of there and they're crudely glued on. They're horrible. But I add two elastic bands in there just to hold them in place and still give me enough movement. So then when I need to move, I have that little bit of leeway. So I mean, they're all elastic. They can obviously, you know, get caught up and bunched out of the way they're supposed to be. That's just one of the other modifications I did to this armor. One of the other modifications I did was adding these almost like overall kind of straps to the ab plate. This is literally just there to basically help me put everything on, and I'll show you guys here in a second as I take it off, and to help kind of hold it up in place just in case this does start to slip down too low or the back plate or kidney plate slips a little bit. This is just there to kind of help hold everything in place. The belt, from what I've seen from a lot of actual movie armor, like movie accurate armors, is that the belt is actually separate and has a fabric piece. This belt is actually riveted to the ab plate and then it has a plastic belt. I don't know if there's a benefit or a negative to this. I don't know what the benefits are to this part being fabric versus plastic. Maybe just the sake of durability, I'm not positive, but that's how this one is, and for me, it works. I have Velcro right here, holding belt on, and then the Velcro that came on it right here. And then I have another strip of Velcro back here, just to help, I don't know if you guys can see that, just to help hold the kidney plate kind of in place. I have Velcro on the strap and then Velcro on the kidney plate. So here's my plastic overalls strapping mechanism going on here. You guys can see inside here where the straps were that were Velcroed to the armor. Or I'm sorry, not Velcroed. You guys can see inside here where these straps were actually, well, basically the strap housing is molded to the plastic. And this is where the straps were holding the ab plate to the chest plate. Again, cut all those straps off, added my own. One of the things here, and I'll get to this in a second, talking about the thigh plates, this is the Velcro that was in place to hold the thigh plates to the ab plate. This is how the armor came. After a while of running the armor like this, I noticed an issue of my thigh plates actually slipping as I was walking and then falling down my shin plates. And when you're at an event, it's very difficult to have to go walk away from out of, you know, anyone's view and fix your armor for a good 5 minutes. It really takes away from the authenticity and the fun of doing an event. So I removed the straps from the thigh plates, or actually didn't even remove them. I just modified them to where they're basically looped around my belt. So we'll get onto that There's the Velcro. This is how it used to be rigged. When you buy this armor, the Rubies armor, it is not separate like this. Mine is separate, and obviously you can see the strap work that I've added on there with the Velcro. From what I can tell, most trooper armors, when you get them, have the back plate and the butt plate, I'm sorry, the kidney plate and the butt plate together. However, you have to cut that yourself. The reason why there's such a big gap between my kidney plate and my butt plate is because I have my armor fitted to be, it's fitted to me. I have it fitted very tightly, so when it's like that, there's not really room for the butt plate to be cinched right up against the back plate on mine. Otherwise, it's not really sitting on my butt, it'll be sitting on my lower back. This is completely optional when you buy this armor. I chose to do this for more mobility. It's more comfortable this way to just add your own straps and cut the butt plate off of the kidney plate. There is kind of a nice little line where you can see where you could cut it. This is, again, completely optional. I did this so I had more mobility and was more comfortable wearing my armor. This is not necessary, but this, when you get it, will be one whole piece. So not that you guys can see a whole lot, but this is how I have my thigh plates rigged on. I took the Velcro straps that were holding to the ab plate and I just made them into pretty little loops so that I had something keeping everything from being all put together as one unit, so I had more mobility. This gives me plenty of movement to basically run, walk, anything. This gives me more mobility and not risking my thigh plates slipping off the Velcro when it's attached to the ab plate. When you receive this armor, it is made for a standard size, so it is made to fit just about anybody. So this is where the original Velcro is, this strip right here. This is where the original Velcro would have sat if I would have left it alone. However, I have little legs, and that's huge on my little legs. So I added just one additional little strip of Velcro right here. This plastic is not as thick as other parts of the armor, so there was no necessity for me to heat this to get it to shape better. I just cinch it up and done. I have no issues. There's still a little bit of Velcro showing sometimes. Just have to be aware of that and just kind of, you know, adjust it a little bit. And then I have my stripes painted on it. Again, when you get this whole armor, it is basically is black all the way through. So if you're looking for movie accuracy, I do not recommend this armor. If you're just looking for armor because you want armor, this is a good start. When I got the armor, one of the first things I did was throw away the bodysuit. Now, first question from a lot of people would be, why would you throw away the bodysuit? It was made to fit a standard size, so it's made to fit just kind of any Joe Schmo. And it fits horrendously. The seam work on it is horrendous. The fit is uncomfortable. Most of the plates were made to basically Velcro to that undersuit. It's just not comfortable. So the first thing I threw out was the undersuit. And now what I wear under my armor is that belt, this shirt, and just any kind of black pair of pants. I'm not going for movie accuracy. I don't have to worry about wearing a specific type of undersuit. I have this, no one notices. I have nothing to worry about. This is your shin plate. This is the standard. This is the shin plate that comes with the armor. One of the things that's really difficult with this, and it depends on how you're trying to put it on, is it's very stiff. There is not a lot of room for flex along the seam. My other shin plate actually cracked right up the middle, probably about to here, because it has really no give to it. So if you're pulling it open to fit over your shin, you are gonna risk this breaking. If you can figure out how to kind of slide your foot in, then you will save this for a lot longer. One of the things that I do recommend you do when you get this armor is definitely take a Dremel and just kind of widen out this whole area. Give yourself a little more, just a little more comfortability, especially when you're wearing boots. If you have the correct boots, they're gonna wanna kind of pop out of the, out of underneath the shin plate, and you don't really want that. It's kind of a pain to try and fix that when you're in costume. Bending over that far to try and fix your shin plate, it's not always the best. Doesn't work very well. Again, this armor is made to fit a standard size person, so the Velcro is, and I have reshaped this shin plate with the heat gun, so it's a little more difficult to see, but here's the original Velcro on that line right there. There you go, on that line right there. So that's where the original Velcro would have sat, would have been a really big opening. So now I've only added a couple strips, just a strip right there, and then a strip towards the bottom right there, just to help cinch it up around my skinny little calves. Now, this is still really big. I had to put foam inserts just to keep this sitting properly on my shin. It's still kind of big. I would definitely recommend, if you're gonna replace any part of the armor, I would definitely recommend the shin plates.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in for this video. I know I don't make nearly enough content for YouTube, but I do appreciate you guys tuning in. I hope you found value in watching this YouTube video. Hope this kind of gives you a little bit of an ease when it comes to looking for your trooper armor, of trying to, you know, be a stormtrooper in real life. I hope this gives you ease. If you enjoy my content here and you're new, please bump over to all my other social media and even bump over to my Etsy shop. I have hats, I have posters, I have t-shirts, I have all kinds of stuff on my Etsy shop, either featuring my artwork or featuring other artwork that I've done that has nothing to do with me. Bump over to my TikTok, follow me there. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys next time.